Hello, my name is Joe Lauer, and I'm with the University of Wisconsin-Madison, the Agronomy Department. And today what we're going to talk about is corn replanting decisions. This time of year, especially early part of May, after planting has occurred, farmers need to get out and evaluate the kind of stand that they've got in their fields. There are really six parts to this whole this decision. The first part is to determine the stand that you have out there after you've planted. And the easiest way to do that is to measure out 1/1000th of an acre, which on 30-inch rows is 17 feet 5 inches, but there are a number of tables that can help with that conversion. But count the number of plants in that distance and then multiply by 1,000, and that'd be the number of plants per acre that you have. Second step in this process is to evaluate the health of the plants that are there. And this is very difficult to do. The third step in this process is to assess the variability of the stand. Are there plants still emerging? Are they emerging later? Are there doubles and gaps in the stand? All those things can decrease yield later on. The fourth step is probably one of the most difficult to get because you have to have quite a bit of data for this, and a number of extension programs have this for different states. We in Wisconsin have got a table that basically looks at the yield performance of a full and a shorter season hybrid planted at various dates during the planting season, and then looking at the impact of plant population on that overall optimum yield and time that you would plant corn at. So what you have to do is look at the date that you planted the corn at, the stand that you've got, then look at when you would replant the field, and look at the expected stand that you could expect later on, and see if that yield is going to be of any benefit to you later on. The fifth step is then to replant, is to recalculate the planting costs that are associated with planting that corn stand a second time. And then finally, the sixth step is to look at the risk associated with that replanting. Just because you're going to replant doesn't mean you're going to get 100% stand again. There may be still some problems in the field that you just can't overcome or won't be able to overcome this season. And you have to assess that risk a little bit. This is a good example of where you might have some gaps in the stand, where you've got nice even distribution here, but then you had two or three plants that did not emerge for various reasons, probably due to some ponding or surface crusting that went on. And again, you hopefully won't have too many of these gaps. Basically, if you have every other plant as a gap, then you're looking at some yield decreases. Here's an example of a stand that isn't very even in terms of variability, in that we've got, in this case here, a triple going on. Here we've got a double, and then the spacing isn't very even in this part of the row here. And again, assessing the implications of this is difficult because plants have a tremendous capacity to compensate for different spacings and things, but more than likely there's going to be some stress that's going to go on during the growing season that's going to cause some yield impacts with this group of plants right here. An example of corn that's in fairly good spacing and fairly even emergence, although there are some plants that are a little bit off, but you can see that there's fairly good spacing. This one's a little close, but this would certainly be something that's acceptable as far as what we call a good stand of corn.